Hi, on the Woodpecker today, I make some modification to my drum sander. I really love my drum sander. When a board goes through it, I end up with a nice flat sanded piece. But I don't like the fact that if I try to remove too much wood too quickly, the mortar overheats and its breaker jumps. I have to wait about 2 minutes before I can start it again. To avoid that, I have to manually lower the feed rate before the breaker jumps. I want to make something that will lower the speed automatically. So I'm trying my area with this proto board. And since after my test I was confident it would work, it's time to get my hands dirty. First, I want my controller just here in this plastic box. I'm beginning with the most important piece, the stepper motor. After drilling a small hole where I want the motor shaft, I turn the box and drill the final hole. This is a very good start. I have my motor, and if I look at it closely, it's perfect. But I'm far from being finished. I need to fix the box here. So, using a salsa jar, I trace the feed motor's shape and cut it. Now I can cut this to the right length. I also need to make some space for the motor's pulley. So after marking it, I drill the holes. Okay, first try is not a success. Or the second. Or the third. But after that, I add a wood block to help me. This goes much better. Next, to hold this block to the motor, I need to cut two slots to hold it in place. I begin by drilling a series of small holes and cut the slot on the scroll saw. Then I use the slots and mark the case and cut more slots. Now I can glue the motor in place. And I can try this in place. To hold the display in place, I drew the shape, which is supposed to be the shape of the display, and cut it. When the CNC cutting is done, I finish the job with the scroll saw. I guess I didn't take the right measurements. The display doesn't fit. Nothing that a rasp can fix. Now the display fits. I still need to remove some wood here. This will be perfect. I need to drill the plastic box now. I begin by sticking the wooden pattern inside the cover and drill for the buttons and the display. Then, using the scroll saw, I cut the display hole. This is not that bad. But I need something to press on the button. For that, I'm going to use knife's rivets. I begin by enlarging the small holes I made. Then I put together both pieces of the rivets. It's not perfect, but it's working. But now, when I put everything in place, I can see it's starting to take shape. But it's not done yet. All the wires and electrical connections have to be inside the box. But for that, I need to drill more holes. When I'm done, I pass the wires through their holes and make the electrical hookup. While doing that, I also put the current sensor in place. Then I can put the box in place. I also need to stick some tape to prevent short circuits. And now I'm ready to try this. First, I draw this plan, and with this nice plan, I make my first prototype. I only need to hook up some wires and the display, and I'm ready for my first trial. Perfect! I'm very happy. So after this success, I decide to design this PCB. This will be much better. So 1 week later, when I receive my board, I can solder all the components. I know, there's nothing interesting in assembling a circuit board. But here it is anyway, completely assembled. It looks much better than my prototype. Speaking of the devil, it's now ready for retirement and getting replaced by my new circuit. This is number one. But to please Arduino's fans, I bought one, just to see if I can replace my circuits with one. But to do so, I need to add a prototype circuit sandwiched between the Arduino and the display. That's the circuit all assembled. And that's what it looks like when I put all this together. And this gave me the idea to design my own prototype hybrid circuit with a microcontroller directly on the board. And that's the look of it. And with simple code modification, the Arduino or my own hybrid circuit works just like my original design. And here's a demonstration of the circuits working. As you can see, when the motor's currents exceed 9 amps, the stepper motor reduces the speed of the feed rate and the motor uses less power. You can see it right here. Next, the feed rate gradually increases but never exceeds 9 amps. Otherwise, it would lower the feed rate again. I don't have a lot of options in this controller. So after a welcoming message, I can lower the maximum feed rate. As you can see, each time I press the button, the speed slows down. The faster button increases the speed. I can also reset the controller at this particular place. And now the absolute position is reset to 10,000. Now, if I lower the speed and press the home button, the stepper motor returns to its home position, which is 10,000. Now, I can just hope that my future sanding frenzies will go much faster thanks to this modification. If you wish to have more info on the electronic circuits, just visit my website. And see you soon for another episode of The Woodpecker.